Capital Area Food Bank, moving forward in partnership with our agencies, our partner nonprofits that stand here with me, will make a commitment over the next 4 years to expand outreach, to build a closer relationship with Health and Human Services Commission here in Austin. And through our partnerships with the Texas Food Bank Network and Feeding America nationally, we will both advocate for and expand our reach and ensure more and more Texans that are eligible for nutrition assistance receive those benefits. Mayor Leffingwell and Deputy Commissioner DeBerry mentioned summer feeding programs. 7% of our households with children, 7% of our households with children, of our client households with children, access summer feeding programs here in Central Texas. That number is completely unacceptable. It is unacceptable for a program that is funded. It is unacceptable for a community to allow that to occur. Capital Area Food Bank, after 28 years of standing on the sidelines, is committed to stepping in this year. We will pilot 20 sites for summer feeding here in the Austin area this year with a commitment over the next 3 years to expand that and grow that up to a number and ensure that 4 years from now when we gather, it won't be 7% of our households with children. 7% of the households this network serves with children participating in that program, that number will be significantly higher. So after we've made that commitment as a community, as a state, as an organization, and as a network to ensure those that are eligible for benefits are receiving those, where do we go next? We must ensure, as an organization and as a network, as a community and a state, that those not eligible for benefits, not eligible for nutrition assistance, but in need of food, receive important programs, and receive important services. To that end, Capital Area Food Bank and this network distributed 23 million pounds of food last year, 18 million meals to those in need. Significant jump from a three-year average before that of 15.1 million pounds of food. But we must do more. In order to close the gap between those that are going in an extremely long period of time or an extended period of time without food at all, more food must be put into the system. Expanded programs in outreach programs like the Capital Area Food Bank's mobile food pantry. And we intend to make that happen. The third and most important element to this entire list of three important things that it takes to reduce or end hunger in a community is that we must all embrace the belief, the core value that hunger, especially in the life of a child, is unacceptable. It's morally, it's socially, and it's economically unacceptable. We embrace that as a community, as a state. We embrace that core belief and then act upon that belief as an advocate, as a donor or volunteer. We can sustain the efforts of ensuring those that qualify for benefits receive those benefits and ensure those who don't qualify for benefits receive the food they need. We can sustain those efforts over time. So today we release a report. As I said, it is available at hungerisunacceptable.com. The full report is available for download. We release a report with news that says our neighbors are suffering. The challenges are great. But at the same time, the solution is there. This network is capable of achieving great things. I salute every one of these agencies, these partner nonprofits, all across Central Texas for the work that they do every day. It's amazing work, looking every day when they open up the doors at a line that's longer, a line that's more complex, a line that has more children than it had just 4 years ago. 4 years ago, Capital Area Food Bank and our partner agencies served about 156,000 clients. This past year, we served nearly 300,000. Together, if we embrace the concept of belief that hunger is unacceptable and act on that belief, then next 4 years, when we sit here, we come here to City Hall and report again, we can actually make that number smaller. So thank you all for being here today. Thank you all, our partner agencies, our collaborative partners, the largest nonprofit network serving one particular cause here in Central Texas. I applaud their work. Thank you again for being here. Thank you, Deputy Commissioner DeBerry and Mayor Leffingwell for being here as well. With that, I will open up the floor to questions. If Deputy Commissioner DeBerry would like to join us, if the mayor is still here, we'll open up the floor.